Well, welcome to St. Michael's. And a Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Do you just want to wave Happy New Year to everybody and say, Happy New Year, Happy New Year, Happy New Year. May God enable it to be a blessed one for us all. We're going to be thinking a bit about New Year and a bit about Epiphany as we go through this service. One or two notices. I do hope that your New Year, you may be seated, sorry. I do hope your New Year's resolutions are going well so far. 24 hours is not too bad, is it? And I hope your Christmases were as good as possible, given some restrictions on circumstances. One or two notices. The ladies' breakfast is on the 16th of January. You need to book with Carol this time, I believe. Is that right, Carol? Yep. So do let her know if you want to go. And Alpha will begin on the 11th of January. We will put in things of a COVID secure nature, but we will still be meeting. If interested, please let Andy or Liz know. We have one or two spaces if people are interested. Sadly, we're not going to offer coffee today, and we would like you to keep your masks on because of COVID. But I have two pieces of good news. The first is Caroline, who we've been praying for, has made significant improvements. So our prayers have been answered. God has been merciful. So do be thankful for that. The other piece of incredibly good news is that there's been an engagement. And that is Sarah and Kelvin. So, hooray! So it's lovely to start the new year on such a positive note. I'm just going to say a prayer for Sarah and Kelvin. So let's just pause for a moment. Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing Sarah and Kelvin together, for the friendship and the love that they have for each other, and pray that you'll be with them as they prepare for marriage. Bless them, protect them, and guide them, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
So much love to you both.
Yes.
Now we're going to pause. And we're going to start our service. So let's just be quiet and remember the Lord who loves us, the Lord who came amongst us. Lord God, you revealed your Son to the nations by the guidance of a star. Lead us to your glory in heaven by the light of faith. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Say together, Lord Jesus, thank you that you came to bring us light and life. And so as we start a new year together, send your Holy Spirit to help us follow you, to help us live in your light, and to help us worship you as you deserve. Amen. And of course, today being the day we think about Epiphany, we're going to sing about the wise men, the king. So please stand, and We Three Kings.
Thank you.
please now be seated. As we start a new year, it's a good opportunity to quietly reflect for a moment about any regrets or failures of the past year that we wish to bring to the Lord so that we can hand them over, receive his forgiveness and start afresh. So let's just pause for a moment. When the Lord comes, he will bring to light the things now hidden in darkness and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us confess our sins. God, be gracious to us and bless us, and make your face to shine upon us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May your ways be known on the earth, your saving power among the nations. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You, Lord, have made known your salvation and revealed your justice in the sight of the nations. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God, who sent his Son into the world to save sinners, bring us his pardon and peace, now and forever. Amen. So now we come to our reading, and Caroline will read for us. Thank you.
The reading this morning is taken from Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. Visitors from the East. Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the time when Herod was king. Soon afterwards, some men who studied the stars came from the east to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the baby born to be the king of the Jews? We saw his star when it came up in the east, and we have come to worship him." When King Herod heard about this, he was very upset, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem. He called together all the chief priests and the teachers of the law and asked them, "Where will the Messiah be born?" "In the town of Bethlehem in Judea," they answered. "For this is what the prophet wrote, 'Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, you are by no means the least of the leading cities of Judah, for from you will come a leader who will guide my people Israel.'" So Herod called the visitors from the east to a secret meeting and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem with these instructions: "Go and make a careful search for the child, and when you find him, let me know, so that I too may go and worship him." So they left, and on their way they saw the same star they had seen in the east. When they saw it, how happy they were, what joy was theirs. It went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. They went into the house, and when they saw the child with his mother Mary, they knelt down and worshipped him. They brought out their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and presented them to him. Then they returned to their country by another road, since God had warned them in a dream not to go back to Herod. After John was put in prison, Jesus went into Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God. "The time has come," he said, "the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe the good news." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, O Christ. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you once more that you came amongst us as the baby of Bethlehem, and that you are still with us by the power of your Holy Spirit. We pray that as we think together about the journey of the Magi, and their finding of you, that you will inspire and challenge us as we start a new year together. In Jesus' name, amen. So the 12 days of Christmas came to an end on January the 6th. Well, they come to an end, sorry. It's not quite January the 6th, is it? And the season of the Epiphany begins. But Epiphany not only ends Christmas, but it kind of fulfills it by celebrating the revelation of the Christ, the Messiah, God's Son, to the whole world. Epiphany is when we think about the wise men finding Jesus by following a star. Now, this is a slightly adapted version of what could have happened. It's not politically correct, but I find it fun. If three wise women had set out to find Jesus, they would have asked for directions, arrived on time, helped deliver the baby, cleaned the stable, made a casserole, and brought nappies, baby grows, and a rattle as their gifts. More seriously, we're going to consider the wise men of Matthew's gospel. The sign. The sign. Sometime after Jesus was born in Bethlehem, Magi, our wise men, came to Jerusalem, where King Herod was the king. They asked, "Where is the baby born to be the king of the Jews? We saw his star when it came up in the east, and we have come to worship him." The Magi, or wise men, were probably astrologers or astronomers who studied the stars, and they came from the east of Israel, possibly Persia. By the way, why was the homeless astrologer turned away from the hostel? Because there was no moon at the inn. 2022 is not going to get any better for jokes. So the Magi were not Jews. And yet they must have known something about the Jewish scriptures and the promise of a special king who would come to save his people and shine a light for the Gentiles. So the Magi remind us that Jesus came for everybody of all nationalities and backgrounds, came for you and me. Now God gives us signs that he's at work and calling us to find him. God used the natural world to give the wise men a sign, a star, and he calls us to seek him in various ways. Perhaps when we ponder the beauty of our natural world, or man-made beauty, such as we might find in churches or a cathedral, or when we see a beautiful painting or hear lovely music. God sometimes uses scripture, sometimes uses somebody who knows scripture, sometimes uses a parent, a family member, a friend, a priest, the author of a book, all sorts of people. But reflect for a moment, what signs might God be using to call you to seek him? And how do you need to find space for that? Are you willing to respond? We need to be like the wise man who responded to the sign by seeking Jesus. Now the search. This is my grumpy camel. The Magi travel far and spend much time and energy on their search. When they arrive in Jerusalem, they find a very confusing situation, perhaps discouraging, because the reigning king, King Herod, knows nothing of the birth of this new king. To them, it seemed likely the newborn king would be related to the current king. So his surprise was a bit shocking. But Herod was more than surprised. He felt threatened. He wanted more information about this king. So he called on the religious leaders to help. They'd opened the sacred writings and they found that the birth of this king was of great religious significance and was to be found in Bethlehem. The religious leaders, though, don't they seem sceptical? They made no attempt to go with the Magi to check out this event, which was of religious importance. Undeterred, the Magi carry on with their search. They're not like Herod. They don't want to kill the baby king, and they're not going to give up. They're going to find Jesus. Let's remember, that those around us may mock us, be completely uninterested, but we must persevere, for Jesus is worth searching for. And the treasure, it's not a very big treasure box, apologies. The Magi left, and on their way they saw the same star they'd seen in the east. When they saw it, how happy they were. What joy was theirs! It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. They went into the house, and when they saw the child, they knelt down and worshipped. They had little information, but they set out and continued to follow the direction God called them to. Their journey's end comes when they enter a house. We often think of the Magi as coming Christmas night to the cave or stable, as in the nativity sets. But Mary, Joseph, and Jesus are now in a house. After all, better accommodation would have been needed after just a couple of days. And it could have been up to 2 years since the birth when the Magi arrived. But they're overjoyed. Their search is over. They bow down and worship Jesus, knowing the unlikely king as he is of significance. Because you see, Jesus is the greatest treasure we can ever find. He is God come to be with us. Through him, we can have a relationship with the Almighty, our Creator. Through him, we're forgiven. We're promised eternal life, life with him forever. Through him, we're assured of the love of God and the presence of God with us day by day. There is a cost, though, to faith in Jesus. There is the cost of the search, of course. But there is a cost in the response we're compelled by love to give to Jesus. See, Jesus doesn't actually make any demands of us, but he invites us. He invites us to follow him as his faithful disciples. The Magi are moved to give three gifts to Jesus, and perhaps we can see those gifts as symbolic of the cost of discipleship. Oh, I've spilt my coins everywhere. First of all, there's gold, isn't there? Gold coins, perhaps. Do they represent our money and our possessions? Are we prepared to offer all we have to Jesus, our King, so that he can direct how we'll use all the resources he's given us in this new year? Then they presented him with frankincense, deliberately wrapped up, as I don't have anything highly appropriate. This could represent our worship. Are we able to commit to worshipping Jesus wholeheartedly in 2022? This could be through daily prayer and Bible reading. It could be through the loving service of others in his name. It could be regular participation in Holy Communion and the worship of the church. It could be attending Bible study. It could be other ways that perhaps you are aware of. And they presented him with myrrh. Myrrh is usually understood as a burial ointment and points towards the death of Jesus for us, but it could also symbolize our own willingness to die to selfish desires. Because selfish desires pull us away from Jesus. So we need to offer them to him so he can set us free from them. So I'm going to invite you to pause for a moment now and think about your New Year resolutions for 2022. And why not add to them something about seeking Jesus and being willing to offer him our resources, being willing to commit to deeper worship, being willing to make sacrifices of selfish desires to follow him. So just pause for a moment and think and reflect. I wish you joy in searching as you follow the signs and seek the treasure beyond price. And as we discover more of the love of Jesus for each one of us, may we all be willing to follow him more closely and present him with our offerings of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, or whatever they represent in our own lives. Amen. Let's now encourage each other by declaring our faith in God. So please stand. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please remain standing, and we're going to have our next carol, The First Noel. So let's enjoy singing The First Noel together. seated. And sorry about the confusion over verses, but you did very well. And the important thing is you all knew the chorus, so that was fine, wasn't it? Now we come to our time of prayer, and Marianne will lead us on Zoom.
Be still, for the presence of the Lord, the Holy One, is here. The power of the Lord is moving in this place. Father, you have called us and placed your name on our lips. We are your church, your pilgrim people. We ask you to open for us a future that is bright and new. We ask forgiveness for past faults, for the pride that has kept us apart. Forgive your church if it has not been worthy of your trust. Help us to seek unity and to bring peace to all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer. Lord of the years, we ask your blessing on the year to come. Give us the resilience to bear its disappointments. Give us energy to seize its opportunities. Give us openness to accept the more abundant life which you offer through your Son. We ask that the progress made in fighting the pandemic will continue apace. We thank you for all the happy memories of 2021, and we look to the future with hope in our hearts. In our cycle of prayer, we pray for the people of Sri Lanka. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we give thanks for giving us so much to enjoy in our world. Open our eyes to all the beauty around us. Help us to appreciate your greatness in giving us different seasons. If we do not understand the bad things that can happen, help us to trust where we cannot see and know that you love us all. Make us willing and eager to share the many good things you have provided. We pray this week for the Mickleham Children's Playground Association and for the residents of Pilgrim's Way. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for those in need, especially children. Some would learn but have no teacher. Some are sick but have no doctor. Some are sad and have no one to comfort them. Some children are desperately hungry and poor, and some endure terrible cruelty. For all in need, we ask your loving care. We ask for the powerful gift of hope in seemingly hopeless situations. Let your light shine brightly and let your kingdom come. We pray for Caroline Bennett, who is seriously ill in hospital. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, let eternal light shine on all who have died in your grace. May they rest in peace. Console and strengthen those who mourn. Give them a sense of your presence. You are always near, and we are with you and them forever. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May the love of the Lord Jesus draw us to himself. May the power of the Lord Jesus strengthen us in his service. And may the joy of the Lord Jesus fill our souls. We offer these and all our prayers in your name, Jesus, Son of the living God, who came that we may have life in all its fullness. Amen.
Amen. Let's join together in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. I want us now to just reflect on the coming year. I think I overlooked what I think is a lovely video. So if Kelvin can play for us, Wise Men Still Follow, this might help our reflections as we prepare to say the Wesley Covenant prayer of committing ourselves to the Lord this new year. Sorry, Kelvin. Thank you.
The Virgin Mary had a babe and gently laid him on the hay. The angels came and sang their song. The shepherds hastily went along. They gazed at him with wondering eyes. The King whom all salvation lies, on bended knee they worshipped him, the one who'd save us from our sins. For this is Christmas, our favorite story. The seeking wise men saw the star. They traveled to him from afar. With frankincense and gold and myrrh, they gave the babe their gift so pure. Our Savior led a perfect life, despite the hate and cruel strife. He walked the path that we should go. Our gift to him is what we sow. For this is Christmas, our favorite story. But how do we glory in him above? Wise men still see
We're now going to say the Wesley Covenant Prayer, and I invite you in your hearts to join in. I am no longer my own, but yours. Put me to what you will. Rank me with whom you will. Put me to doing, put me to suffering. Let me be employed for you or laid aside for you, exalted for you or brought low for you. Let me be full, let me be empty. Let me have all things, let me have nothing. I freely and wholeheartedly yield all things to your pleasure and disposal. And now, glorious and blessed God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you are mine and I am yours. so be it. And the covenant now made on earth, let it be ratified in heaven. Amen. So now we have our final carol. If you'd like to stand, as with gladness, men of old did the guiding star behold. Please remain standing for the blessing. The God who called us here is sending us out to turn words into deeds, worship into service, and vision into reality. Together we have celebrated our faith. Now let us share it in the name of Christ and in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon each of you and those you love, today and always. Amen. It's been good to be together. Once more, apologies for the glitches, and I hope you do have a very happy new year, and I look forward to working with you for a whole year ahead. So do keep coming, keep serving, keep loving, and we'll go far as a church. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Blessing, honor, and glory be yours, here and everywhere, now and forever. Amen. Well, there's a short New Year DVD now, just wishing you blessing.